great to be here at Plastron. This is an example of a high-tech manufacturer right here in West Michigan for the aerospace industry, making advanced materials for fighter aircraft, for commercial aircraft, as well as materials for the SLS rocket ship, which is the NASA rocket ship that's going to take us back to the moon and in a little over a decade to Mars. Now, here is a manufacturing plant in West Michigan that's contributing to a mission to Mars. Very exciting to see the advanced technology that's being done here, the skilled workers that are here. That's why we have to continue to train workers that can work in production facilities like this across the state. One thing that I hear, and here at Plastron as well as other places, people are looking for skilled workers and still can't find enough of those. That's why I'm working to expand skills training and career training. I have many individuals, they don't need to get a two-year degree or four-year degree. There are great jobs, great middle-class jobs in high-tech manufacturing like here at Plastron. And I want to come here firsthand to learn more about the company, talk to the leadership here about some of the challenges that they have and the ways in Washington that we can address them. Well, I think it'll impact West Michigan to make sure that employees are available. There are many openings right here that are unfilled because people just don't have some of the basic skills necessary to work on the production floor. And what we're finding is that's one of the number one impediments to growth right now. It's just simply finding people that have the skills that they need. And that's even just some basic skills. The companies will often train individuals to have the specific skills necessary for that operation. But if you don't have those people, you can't grow your business, you can't grow the economy, and that'll put a cap on the growth that we're seeing here in West Michigan. There are a lot of exciting things happening here in West Michigan. I'm always excited to spend time here. Things are changing rapidly, but we have to make sure we have folks with the right skills coming to the area to take these jobs. Well, it is. We need to get in to see those facilities. I requested to go in. We were told we needed at least 2 weeks advance notice to be able to see the facility specifically. I wanted to sit down though with the leadership of Nutrition Services to find out what is happening to get a better sense of these children that are there. But most importantly, we've got to make sure these children are returned to their parents. Bethany made that commitment today that they're doing everything they can to make sure that these children are back and with their parents. They've identified where those parents are. I was encouraged to hear that the children there are able to call their parents and talk to their parents. What I was disturbed to hear was that doesn't necessarily mean every day. There are some facilities where these parents are being held and they simply don't let their children talk to them for sometimes as long as a week. That's simply unacceptable. Children should be able to talk to their parents at least on a daily basis. Well, certainly we have to make sure our borders are secure. That's always number one. I am a member of the Homeland Security Committee of the United States Senate. That's what I work on each and every day, is to make sure that the homeland is safe. But we should look at comprehensive reforms so that allow us to bring in folks, particularly in jobs that we need in this country. Agricultural jobs, for example, one thing I hear on the west side of the state is the need for workers. But that has to be done through a comprehensive immigration policy that's done with proper vetting. Security first, but there are other issues that we need to address to make sure that this country continues to be the country that it always has been, which is welcoming to immigrants through a legal process that contribute to our country. Well, I would hope that we could return to the days when the Supreme Court nominees could win support in a bipartisan way. In the past, our nominees have always done that. It's what's in the best interest of the country, where you try to find the most qualified jurists that are going to look at issues based on the law and with an open mind, not be ideologically predisposed to one way or the other. And the only way you do that is if you can do it in a bipartisan way. We have to return to that. I'm hopeful President Trump will nominate someone like that. I don't know if that will happen. I think many of us are concerned he won't, and he will try to just jam a nominee through on a strictly partisan basis. But I don't think that's in the best interest of the country, certainly with a jurist that may be on the Supreme Court for decades. We need to think about a broad action when it comes to weapons and firearms. You know, I'm a gun owner and believe in the Second Amendment, but I think there's some common sense things we can do to hopefully reduce some of the gun violence we see. It's important to put in perspective, as horrible as the event was, that over 90 people every single day die as a result of gun violence in this country. One thing that I think we can do, we should do, and the American people agree that we must do, and that's make sure that we have comprehensive background checks for folks. Right now, up to 40% of all weapons sold in this country are done without a background check. There's no question that lives could be saved as a result of that. It can't prevent all gun violence, but I think it would give us a meaningful step to reduce the horrible violence that we see in this country every day.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm good.